What is up, y'all? This is Alex from Alex PC Tech again, back at you with another video. And on this video, we're gonna be taking our first look at the Mercury Speedster 319 series. This time, we're gonna be looking at the 6900 XT. Now, this is not just the base 6900 XT. This is actually the Black Edition, as you can see here. So Black Edition, but wait, we have another surprise for you, as we're not gonna be taking our first look at one, but two 6900 XT variants from XFX. This one that we have here is actually the Ultra Edition, okay? So Black and Ultra, Black and Ultra, Black and Ultra, okay? So let's take a look and have or see what are the basic or physical differences between these two cards, and roll intro. What we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be unboxing this one first, and after that, we're gonna be comparing it against the Ultra. Okay, so I'm quite excited what our DNA 2 Gen 1 has in store for us in terms of the 6900 XT. Okay, it has the shoebox design again. Let's see what we have. Okay, again, the driver notice and a basic startup guide for the monitor connections and for the GPU. And then finally, this is the GPU. Okay, let's remove it from the box. Okay, basic. No connectors, only manuals, no drivers, just the GPU. So this is actually a anti-static plastic as well, as you can see. XFX is really very minimal in terms of their packaging, not compared to other brands, but I like it, as this is really what you are buying, not all the other frills and chills. But it's also nice if they included some decals for the XFX brand. Looking at the card, looking at the weight, it's actually the same as the one that we've previously unboxed, the 6800. But guys, I'm really curious, why aren't you subscribing? That video already has 1,200 views, but only we have who subscribed from that. So if you are watching this video, please do subscribe, as we will be pumping out content such as this, and we are actually planning to upgrade our unboxing and first look to actually test these cards. So if you would like us to do that, just subscribe, as we will be doing that. Okay, so let's remove it from the anti-static bag. Okay, pack. Oh, I like that they actually measured these up to size, the plastic. And for the scotch or the tape, it's not really a tape that's thick throughout. There's a little portion where you can like hold it and then rip it. Yeah, and then let's remove it. Get. Oh, look at that. So this is the Black Edition, as you can see. So Black Edition, what do we have here? We still have the aluminum shroud that is with the XFX. Okay, they've implemented this design on the 319 Mercury Speedster series. And then for the fans, we still have the 13-bladed ball bearing fans to promote longevity and performance of the card. By the way, if you haven't known, Mercury 319 is because they have three fans. Two is at 100 millimeters, one is at 90 millimeters. So 319, that's how they named their card. So if you happen to know why they use this formula, or on which photosynthesis or scientific formula they based this naming convention on their cards, please comment down below. But XFX, you've done a really good job with designing this card, okay? So looking at the front, it still has the protruded light bar to promote more airflow. And then looking at the side of the card, we still have the aluminum mounting mechanism. So this is actually really rigid, okay? If you ask me, this aluminum card will actually prevent sagging, provided that you mount your card properly. As for the display, we have two display ports at 1.4B for 8K at 60, 4K at 120Hz, one HDMI 2.1 for 4K 144Hz, and a USB-C port for VR applications. Looking at the side of the card, we still have the aluminum fins. Although I'm not really sure how many aluminum fins did they fit with this card. Let's find out. And then we have the power connectors, the two dual PCIe 8-pin power connectors. The previous iteration of this card, the 6900 XT from XFX itself, actually recommends you to have an 850-watt power supply. So I guess in this case, on the 6900 XT Black Edition, you'll be needing more juice. As why are you gonna buy this? It's because of its, of course, overclocking or boost clock headroom, which will actually require more power in some cases. So I would really recommend having a higher power supply if you're aiming for these enthusiast cards, in my opinion, okay? So looking at this side, you can see that the aluminum shroud is lifted. So what I like about this right now upon seeing it is that this is actually, again, a non-RGB light bar, okay? Looking at the back, as you can see, we still have the Merc decal, but now it is in black compared to the other versions. Upon looking at the back, we still have the Merc decal, but on this version, on this iteration, the Merc is actually printed black, which is it's very nice, actually. I really like how they are doing this. XFX, continue what you're doing, and please raise your designers, whoever you people are. I like the design, as this is actually an engineered black backplate. Backplate, as it promotes more airflow with these holes or cutouts that they provided. As you can see, this even has a pass-through for the air to properly be ventilated. Upon checking, the PCB is smaller than the cooler itself, so we have a pass-through of air here to blow more airflow in the card. And as you can see, I've been checking the sides, okay? Upon checking the sides, this backplate actually serves also as a heat dissipator, as there are thermal pads included in between the PCB and the backplate. So this is the design, really, of this card is amazing in terms of airflow, in terms of what or how XFX has tuned into the details to promote more airflow in every aspect of the card, starting from the fans to the protruded light bar up to the heat sinks, to the pass-through ventilation that you can see here, and to the cutouts on the backplate itself. Moving on the side, I forgot to say, beside these double 8-pin connectors is a BIOS toggle, okay? This is not the P or Q or the performance or quiet mode or rage mode, but this is actually a BIOS switch where you can fall back to the other BIOS in case you mess up or bricked the previous BIOS that this Radeon or video card has, okay? So moving on, we'll now move on with the other card, which is the Merc 319 Ultra. So we'll set this aside here so that we can instantly check what are the differences between these two cards. We have the black and then we have the Ultra. Actually, I'm really excited with how AMD has been pound for pound, blow by blow, competing against Nvidia, as this is actually the generation where AMD has actually caught up with Nvidia in terms of performance, game performance, okay? In other reviews, the 6900 XT is quite trading blows with the 3090, but it actually depends on each and every title. So other game engines are optimized for AMD, others are optimized for Nvidia. But let's see this Ultra 319. Okay, it still has the shoebox design. And okay, another foam. Okay, another foam. Let's set that aside. As usual, the generic driver notice and the generic startup card. Please, XFX, if you are listening, provide non-generic startup cards. Okay, although I know that this applies to the XFX Speedster series, but it would still be better if you put in the differences or put in extra details about the cards on your startup card. Because, you know, why are we going to buy the Merc Ultra or the Black instead of this one? It would be valuable if you put some differences on the startup cards. Again, these behemoth cards are occupying the entire screen. As you can see, this is how it looks, and we're gonna pop it out of the box in order to check how it looks. Okay, initially looking at them both, they're actually the same size, same weight, okay, but let's see what else is there. Same principle that they did with the Black Edition. The tapes are not really scotched in, but there's this little lever where you can just pull them out. Very thoughtful of you guys. And I like that their anti-static bag is exactly the same size as the card. Not like that, not like with other cards where the anti-static bag goes over the entire card twice. Okay? Ten, 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 ten. Okay. Okay. Any difference? Probably if I switch them in the box, you won't notice, right? This is the Black Edition. This is actually the Ultra. Okay, so first look. Okay, first look at the card. Actually, the Black and the Ultra are very identical in terms of looks. Now, looking at the front of the card, it has the same aluminum shroud. It has the same ball bearing fans, triple design, and they also have 13 blades. So, same. Looking at the top, it still has the protruded light bar that is non-RGB and says Radeon RX 6900 XT. Although the size is actually, like, basically these are some of the biggest cards when it comes to the 6000 series, okay? Still, my ruler wouldn't measure it, okay? But when checking, it's around 330 to 340 millimeters, okay? Same, they have the same size, same length, same dimensions, but what is actually the difference between these two? Okay, so for your information guys, the Ultra and the Black are both 6900 XT variants. In theory, they should have both similar PCBs, similar chips, similar power delivery, no change at all. But the difference between the 319 Black and the base 6900 XT from XFX is that this one has more overclocking headroom. Although the base only has around 25 megahertz increase in base clock compared to the 6800 XT, this one has or is assured to have more overclocking headroom than that of the 6900 XT basic variant. Okay, but when it comes to the Ultra, the XFX Merc 319 Ultra, here the argument is that it is ensured, okay, that you will get the best overclock out of the 319 Mercury Blacks. Okay, it's like they picked all of the Ultras from the Blacks, so all of these are overclocking more higher. This has more overclocking headrooms than the Black Edition. So who would want these graphics cards? Okay, if you're an enthusiast, you like overclocking, and you are going for the 6900 XT. This is actually a viable option, as if you are gonna be not upgrading your card and you're gonna be buying again another card for 5 years, then it's actually better to buy the best of the best now. Although there is really no graphics card that is future-proof you might say. These cards will actually give you the best performance of what RDNA 2 Gen 1 has to offer, as it is the overclocking headroom that you are buying them for. Although we know that the PCB, these PCB versions of the 6900 XTs are like 150 or 150 more, 150 USD dollars more in price in terms of the pricing, okay? This is actually like 200 or this will be around $270 or $300 more than this one. But it is assured that you will get the best overclock out of your 6900 XT with the Ultra Edition compared to the black ones. So please do like if you like this video, as we are planning to step up our game and we are soon to do a benchmarking setup for you guys so that you will be able to decide for yourself if these are really worth your money. So like if you like this video and subscribe if you haven't, and of course see you on the next video.